watching it. People might pop in and say, like, I'll have the chat up anyway. Right, so talk me through the beginnings.
Okay.
What do I need to know?
So, at the start of our turn, we roll for initiative using our influence dice.
Okay, well, teach what's first about the game. What do I need to know? I've got my hero. Do I need to know anything else?
You need to know that the only way you can kill an immortal is to behead them.
Yeah. So this is about a movie of immortals, and they eventually hunt each other down because each time they kill one another, they gain the power of the others. All right.
Okay.
So I've got my immortal, and I'm playing Conor McLeod of the Clan McLeod. And who are you playing?
I'm playing Simon.
All right. Iman Fazil. Fazil, okay. So what do we need to do?
So, do you want to start? So, we start with initiative rolls. So, on here you've got three different dice. You've got the cunning, power and influence.
Yep.
Each of them has a different dice. You've got different types of dice in this game. You've got D4s, D6s, D8s, D10s, D12s, and I think this is a D20.
Okay.
So each of stats has a different dice. So for initiative, you would roll your influence dice. Influence dice for me, that's a D8. So I'd roll this.
Okay, and I get.
And I got a 2.
So I get a D8 as well, yeah? I get a yellow D8. And I got an 8.
So you're going first. Initiative, yeah? So we put this token here. And for me, I get this token.
Okay, this just means I get to go before you go. Okay, cool.
So what you do is you can either place your character here or here. So if you place your character here, then you get to draw the slot card of the hunt. If you place your character here, then you get to roll your influence die. And whatever you get is how many cards you draw.
Okay, so I can choose to either hunt. So explore the encounter deck. If you're alone in this space, upgrade your influence die. Or I can lay low, explore the era deck. If you're alone in this space, upgrade your influence die. Okay. So I get to choose first.
Yeah.
What am I going to find in these decks? Why would I choose to hunt, or why would I choose to lay low? What's
so
in there?
I'm sure with this one that you find you're more likely to find of someone's battle.
Yeah.
And you might. But with this one, you're very likely to find arena cards or life cards, which are basically things you put on here and they upgrade your stats.
Alright, fine. So being this is my first kind of outing then, I'm going to choose to lay low.
So what you do is you roll your influence die.
Okay, so this is my D8. I got 1.
So you get to draw 1 card.
1 card. Have these been shuffled or do you want me to shuffle?
I've shuffled them.
Okay, cool.
And actually, they should be shuffled at the start of the game because you've got these kind of whiter cards that are ancient cards, and then you've got the red ones in here that are modern.
So cool.
So you can change different things.
So I've got a beggar's life. At this last year timeline, I was lost for a time.
So you can just put it here, and what it does is, so you've got minuses on these dice now, though. So that's the influence is now moved down to D6.
Right.
Your power has been moved down to a D4.
Not great.
Your cunning has been moved up to a D6.
Okay. So that's not good.
No.
So influence down to a green one, a D6. Power down to that one. Oh, so I've just become a lot weaker, basically.
Yeah.
Apart from my cunning.
You don't need to put the dice there because since you put this, but I just find it useful to put the dice.
Yeah, I suppose that's right. Yeah. So if you've got enough dice, then just put them next to your card, and then you know exactly what you need to roll. That makes sense.
So I'm going to also lay low.
Okay.
So I got a 7. So I now draw 7 cards.
Whoa.
4, 5, 6, 7. So I can look at all of these, but I can only pick one. So I've got a life of business, I've got a life of greatness, A Laugh of Sorrow.
I put this on my Instagram as well.
A Life of Joy.
Oh, cool.
A Life of Destruction. And A Life of Leadership. So I'm going to choose A Life of Business.
I'm going to take a picture of us playing this. Yeah. So I can put it on Instagram and see if anyone wants to come and see us playing. Right.
So now I shuffle all the other cards that I didn't use back into the deck. So I got A Life of Business, which is plus one on my influence and nice. Plus one on my cunning. So that would be 8 on my cunning and d10 on my influence.
Okay.
So now we have got dueling. No one's dueling. Then we got the end of the turn where we return our initiative tokens to
them. Okay. Oh, actually, do initiative each time, do you?
Yeah. So read out your.
So we're only ever going to need 1 and 2, right?
Yeah. So read out your ability just so everyone knows what it is.
Vengeful. When you discard an ally, you can gain 2 quickening tokens if you have no quickening tokens. So I have no allies at the moment, so I can't do anything with that, right?
Yep. Okay. My one is when I gain a life card, so that's one of these, I get to gain a quickening token. Now, a quickening token is after an immortal rolls a die, he or she may choose to spend a quickening token to re-roll that die. A die may be re-rolled any number of times by spending a quickening token for each re-roll. The tokens are spent before the effect of the roll has been determined. When spending a quickening token, an immortal may spend 1 or more additional tokens to upgrade his or her roll by 1 die. So it's just basically like a re-roll thing.
Alright, cool.
So, can I have a quickening token?
Quickening token for those, yeah.
Yep.
Okay. And what are those used for, man? I know what the quickening is. That's kind of getting ready for the gathering when we all get together and start murdering each other.
But yeah.
So you
use these to re-roll any die that you like.
Okay. So they go there, off the side of the card there to say you've got quickening tokens. Alright, cool. So then we just go back into initiative again, do you?
Yep, so my turn.
So my character comes back here.
You need to roll your influence.
I got 2, so you go first.
See, wouldn't you be on, since your influence got moved down by then, you'd be rolling.
Oh, sorry, you're right. I rolled my cunning. Because my cunning went up, didn't it? I mean, I'm not going to beat a 3.
So you got close.
Yeah. So I'm second to you.
So, I'll go first, and I shall move to the hunt.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't really need to take your character off the board since they're just going to be moving between these two.
Okay. So I'm going to go lay low again because obviously I'd like to get a different life because I'm assuming I can swap this life out, can't I?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
So what I've got here, so I'm fighting.
So you've got Conflict, Ian Starcher, Charismatic, Influence 5.
So what I need to do is roll my Influence dice and get higher.
Roll my 5.
I've got purple dice since my influence has been upgraded from an 8 to a 10.
Oh okay, then you should be right then.
Yeah, that's what I do. Okay. So if you fail that kind of roll, you go into the fail.
Yeah, and you go into the arena.
You place your immortal into arena. Yeah. Each character is different for a success. So I get to place any immortal into the arena. Gain 2 quickening tokens and discard this card. So you are going to go to here. So you wouldn't have actually gone into there because I didn't have to finish my turn.
Alright.
So I now gain 2 quickening tokens.
Okay.
Quite a lot of quickening tokens, right?
Yeah, you're winning, I would say. So what happens here? During the duel phase, all the mortals in the arena roll power. The immortal that rolls the highest power draws a fake card. Okay, fine. So I'm in. So now it's my turn. Am I able to move out of the arena? Or do I have to stay there?
I'm pretty sure you cannot move out of the arena.
Okay, until the end of the turn.
So what this does is during duel phase. So now it's the duel phase.
Yeah, so I can't take any actions, can I? Because I can't actually do anything.
So if there is one immortal in the dueling arena, if it was the top card of the fate deck, discard it. If it was the head, instead of shuffling it back, it's fate deck.
So there's only...
Yeah, so you draw...
So I just draw a fate card. as a behead.
So that you're dead.
But there's no one in there, has there?
It says here, if there's one immortal in the dueling arena, reveal the top card of the fate deck and discard it. If it was a behead card, instead of shuffling it back into the fate deck, instead shuffle it back. Okay, you're fine.
Because it's only me in there. If you had been in there and we were dueling, you would have just cut my head off.
Yeah.
And I'd have died. But because I'm the only person in the arena at the moment, nothing bad happened. So I didn't just get my head cut off on the very first time I went in there. That would be very un-Colin McLeod. Because, you know, he's the one. Right, okay. So then we go back to just doing a new turn.
Yep. So, and if you want, you can take him back.
Yeah. We'll take them back.
So
tokens back into the middle, and then we roll our influence.
Yep, so that's you're now beating your d10, by the way.
Yeah, I know. And I got a 1.
I got a 9.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to go first and move into the hunt.
Okay.
So I drew, so it's an event. Chose and fight. Move yourself and any immortal into the arena. All of our immortals are removed from the arena.
Okay, so it's not going to be me and you, right?
Yep.
So we're both in the arena.
Okay, so now you can't do anything. So dueling, if there is two or more immortals in the dueling arena, all immortals in the dueling arena roll power. The immortal that rolls highest draws a fate card and activates it.
Okay, my power is only a red dice.
Same.
Okay.
They're both very weak.
I got a 2. You got a 1. Okay. Hey, finally. Okay, so I draw a fate card, yeah?
Yep.
Yep, or the loser draws a fate card.
The mortal that rolls highest draws a fate card and activates it.
Okay. Collateral. Choosing a mortal in the arena, that immortal loses an ally. You don't have any allies. Gain a quickening token and discard this card.
Yes, yeah, so basically, you draw a card to deal it to someone else.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. End of turn. And so it's turns fairly quick. We didn't even hand out tokens.
No. I'm surprised I don't get a turn, but I guess that's because I got moved by you.
Yeah.
So I think this is probably a better game with more players, is what I'm sensing. So we're back to rolling our initiative, right?
Okay.
Which is influence, yeah?
Yeah, influence.
I got a 6 and you got a 6.
So we're both going straight into the arena.
Oh, right. We'd like to meet up again, yeah, right. So then it's power versus power.
Yep.
I got a 1.
I got 4.
Okay, so you win.
I got same as you.
Yep, so you get a quickening token, and I don't lose an ally.
Yeah, right, I now want to lay low.
Straight next into the next turn, yeah?
Yep. So I'm rolling my initiative again. I got 5.
I got 4.
Okay, so I'm first. Second, so I'm going to lay low. So I rolled this and I got a 6. So 6 cards.
That seems like a funny thing to do, to pick up 6 cards in one go. You sure that's right?
Yep.
Okay.
Lay low, explore the area deck. To explore the area deck, the immortal rolls their influence and looks at that many cards from the top of the area deck.
Oh, okay.
So 3, 5, 6. Okay. 2, 3, 6. But there is also a twist. So I have now picked up some modern cards and some ancient cards.
Right.
So what you do is you actually discard all of these ones. So also all the ancient cards get discarded. So now I can only pick from the modern cards. So I've got a politician's life,
right,
which is +2 on influence and everything else is neutral.
I basically don't know how to make Instagram work. One second, let me take a picture of us playing and see if anyone wants to come and say hello.
So I've got a more modern life and business, which does the exact same.
So you can choose to swap out if you don't like the life you've got. So obviously mine being a beggar's life, which is debuffing me. If you don't like that life, you can change it, yeah?
Also got a life called a perfect life.
Or does it add to? Can you replace or do you add to lives?
So this is plus... No, you can't add to lives. So once you've got a life, you swap it out for the other one.
Okay.
Okay, so so I'm going to use perfect life. So that would get rid of a life of business. But basically, it just pluses my power as well.
I'm going to put, why not pop by and say hello whilst... James,
that's that.
Teaches me how to play Highlander, the board game.
Yeah, so I'm slightly more buff now instead of having a red power.
There can be only one. I can't believe you've not seen the Highlander, have you? You'd love the Highlander because the Highlander is all Queen music, and you love Queen. In fact, we should stick some Queen music on. 1 second, Alexa. Play me music by Queen from Highlander.
Shuffling songs by Queen on Amazon Music.
Would go
So basically, you just keep, it would be better, it is better. Since
yeah, my power off, goes down.
It takes away one less minus. Because the power is already.
Yeah, but then my power goes down. And I can't fight with a D. I'm going to lose against a D4. So I'm going to go with, a Life of Destruction. And that means that my influence goes down by one, so it becomes a D4. No, my influence goes down by one, becomes a D6. Yeah?
Yep.
Power goes up by one, so it becomes a D8.
And then that's
and the cunning stays as it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's what I'm going to do then. So these two get shuffled back in.
Yeah, shuffled back in. How about this? Go on there.
Okay, good.
Okay. I wanted to get you out the perfect life.
Oh, nice. Perfect life.
Yeah.
When did you get that?
When I drew it out like six cards from there. One of them was the perfect life.
Wow, so just everything goes up.
Yeah. Although there are some that get doubled on a window. And if you want to focus all your stuff on power, then power.
Okay.
So but then... I think that fairly evens out your stuff.
Okay, so what's that's both our turns done. So we come back to the beginning, yeah? Okay, yep. And we roll our influence, yeah?
Yep. Five.
I got five, so we both go into the arena.
Yep.
And then we get our power dice.
So I've no
green. I'm a D8, and a seven.
So you beat me in power.
So I beat in power.
Please don't beat me.
Humiliated. Choose an immortal in the arena. The immortal loses a quickening token, and then I gain a quickening token and discard the card. So I basically get one of your cards, one of your tokens.
Cool.
Okay, so then we go back to our thing, and then we roll again.
Okay.
Right, you ready?
Yep.
So I got a two.
I got six.
Okay, so you're going first.
Cool. So I'm going to lay low. And I got,
I'm going
to
get
to do 5 cards.
5 cards.
So, before I even need to look at them, I'm not going to get to pick between these two, because these are modern, these are ancient. And if you have any modern cards, then you don't get to pick
so is it the ancient. Is it when we run out of cards, apparently?
Yeah, that they govern.
Okay, so when we run out of lay low cards?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, era deck. Okay. So we have the time it takes us to get through the era deck to get as powerful as we can.
Yeah.
So we need to get as powerful as we can, as quickly as we can, before we run out of hero cards.
So I got Politician's Life, and that's basically puts two on my influence, but I'm not going to use that.
Okay.
Next one is the Love of Business, which I actually really had. Man's in car park. All immortals downgrade their power die 2 steps to the arena. I don't want to use these, so I'm going to use this. So let's just not get into any fights until one of us can change the
arena. Okay.
But also what I like about this is if you keep, because when you, let's say you draw 3 cards now, one card's going to get completely got out of the deck.
Yeah, so there's less and less cards in the era deck.
Yeah, that are ancient.
Yeah, okay.
But then the modern
so then it's my turn. So I'm going to go on a hunt then, I think. open warfare. Move yourself and any immortal. So move yourself and any immortal into the arena. Before the duel is turned, each immortal in the arena rolls influence. The immortal that rolls higher upgrades their power dice twice for the duel.
So basically, whoever wins that in the influence doesn't have to suffer from the effects of that.
Okay, right.
That thing will basically counter the
So this is our influence, yeah?
Okay. I have got the advantage of
10. I can't beat you, so it's you. So my power dice is going to go down twice. It goes from a yellow to a green to a red for this battle.
Yeah, so my one would have gone up, but then it would have gone down.
Yeah, so now it's green versus red.
And I've got
a
three.
And I got a two, so you beat me.
So it is the head.
Oh, he killed me.
So you could have beaten me if you want to use I'll let you use one of these cards.
Oh, is that what I would have done with it?
Yeah.
Let's find out. I would have done it once.
So remember, I've got a three.
I got a 4. So but then you would have re-rolled as well, right?
Yeah.
So it's fine. We can't do that, otherwise, like, you genuinely just won that. Yeah. So you just beat me. So let's play again. Let's set up again, and then we'll play again. Because I think we know what we're doing now. So how many cards go into this deck?
So four modern cards for each player, and then
So the white ones are the ancient ones, and the red ones are moderns.
Yep.
So we need to separate those out, right?
I need to go head.
So we'll quickly sort those out.
I'm just
going
to flip back to the setup. So shuffle these. So there's always going to be the head card in there.
Yeah.
But there's also going to be always be two other random ones.
Are you sure the immortal ones aren't the red ones? Because there's a lot more than white ones than there are red ones.
No, because you put six for each player of the ancient cards in.
Okay, so four of these. So there's only six cards in there now.
There's
his. Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
So it's four of these and six of the others.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
For each player. So
yeah, what about this arena card? Where does that go?
That'll go back.
That goes into here.
Yeah, so get eight modern cards down and 12 ancient cards, but don't mix them, because what you do is you place all the modern cards down and you place all the ancient cards on top of them.
So these ones are which? These ones are? These are modern, so yeah. 12 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. There's 8 of those, and they go at the bottom, do they?
Yeah.
Okay, and then 12 of these.
So that's the fate deck. Which is extra three cards.
Oh, so you're bound to get the behead quite a lot then.
Yeah. Well, I think about it, it's playing more players. It's like a character in there.
You sure that's all that goes in the fate deck? Just three cards?
Yeah. Here it says shuffle the behead fate card and two random fate cards there's
to be five cards in there. Yeah. And then there's 8 of these bad boys, and they go on top, yeah?
Yeah.
So that's our era deck. What about the hunt deck? The hunt deck's just all of them?
Yep, so have those back.
And the weapons deck's just all of them?
There's one there, that's just a spare card.
What's spare card?
The lifeguard. So
I'm
just
going to
put it on top.
The ones we're not using. Alright, okay. Cool.
So, yeah, that is the counter deck.
Alright.
Or the hunt deck.
Do you want to be the same guy again?
Yeah.
Alright, cool.
So now, we could just put all your dice in the middle here.
Yep.
Since that bonuses. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let the battle commence.
So
I'm going to start
influence.
I got 6.
I got 4.
So I go first. I'm going to lay low. So I got a 4.
And when you take those 4 cards, you definitely put them back into the deck.
Yeah.
Okay.
You should see.
But then won't you be mixing up the order?
You will, but then that makes time a bit jumbled. Explore the era deck. So explore the era deck. The immortal rolls their influence and not with that many cards from the era deck. This must be. They must pick one of these cards and activate it. After choosing, shuffle the remaining cards and place them back on top of the era deck. If you look at any. Okay, yeah. So yeah, discard them instead.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, so you do
play some battles. So explore the era deck. The immortals roll their influence and look at that many cards from the top of the era deck. Then they must pick one of these cards and activate. After choosing, shuffle the remaining cards and place them back on top of the era deck. If you looked at any modern cards with a red back, discard all ancient cards instead of a turn.
Think about it. Because you're discarding the ancient ones.
You're putting them back on top. Alright, so you shuffle the ones in your hand, so let's say you picked four cards, you pick one of them, you shuffle these ones back and put them on top of the deck again. Once you've gone through those to the red ones, you need to get rid of all of these ones, alright?
Oh, okay.
We don't put them underneath. And I think it's trying to keep a timeline, it's trying to say there's a timeline to the game.
Okay, so I've got an ally, which is learn friends. Discard this card after rolling cunning to replace your roll with 5. I've got number ally, which is spies. Discard this card after a roll to re-roll any cunning die, even if it's Alexa, stop.
Let me find the actual Highlander music.
And then I've got... That'd be good. An event. I've got a pick between an event, 2 allies, and a life. So I've got a life of training, which minuses 1 of my influences and minuses 1 in my cunning, plus is 2 in power. Power is my fading something.
Okay.
I'm going to go with the life of training. So, as soon as you've got it down, just put these cards on top.
Once you've shuffled them.
Yeah, I shuffled them.
From what I understand, that's what you do.
So my cunning is now red. My power is now one of these.
I think you also get to it. It says here, look, if you're alone in this space, upgrade your influence die. So I think when you go in there, as a first player, you would have got to roll a d10 rather. But no, do it for the next turn, but I think you would have got to roll a d10.
But if it's upgrade, then it will stay with you.
I think it's just for while you're alone in there. I don't quite know. It says, if you're alone in this space, upgrade your influence die. So when you're in
the
there.
First one to hunt, then exactly. You'll obviously get the better stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay. All right.
So that's you done, is it?
D6 there. Okay. So, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm currently a red, a green, and a yellow. D4, D6, D8. Okay. So I think then I'm going to try and... Do I want to hunt straight away? No, I feel like I need to get powered first. So I'm going to roll my influence. I get 2. It's not great.
It would be actually, yeah, because you didn't really
move. Okay. Okay, so I can either have learned... So these are cards that you've had because you've just shuffled them and popped them on top.
Yeah.
Learned friends. Discard this card off a roll on cunning to replace your roll with a 5. Okay. Cunning is useful, but not that useful. Discard this card off after a re-roll to re-roll any cunning die, even one you rolled by another
mortal. What time do you think we'll be going? Like, leaving the beach?
I don't know, mate.
It's
20
past 2.
What did you say? Okay, so that's the end of our turn. So we're back to the beginning, yeah?
Yep. Okay. So... One bad thing about this is that my influence is going to be damaged by my life of training.
Alright. I've got 2, so you're going first.
I'll go first. Good. Once you've done your turn, you're meant to flip it over and it's going to rest.
Oh, I see, okay.
No, there's only 2 people, there's no point
to do that. Yeah, it's definitely a game that I think would be better with more players. I mean, funny enough, that is weird for a game that's supposed to be about dueling, but never mind.
Okay, so I've also got to keep an eye out on my abilities. So
yes,
when I gain a lifeguard, I get to gain a booking token. So yeah. I haven't got one from that, but do it now. I missed out.
Oh no, take it. It's any good. You can correct that. That's easy enough to correct.
Okay.
Doesn't break the game or the flow of the game.
But I'm going to move to lay low, so that will upgrade my thing, so I can roll them. 8.
2. 2
only
2 cards.
Put
him
on. Let's see. So I've got
my
friends and
a bunch of children. Do you want to go blow your nose? Like, you sound really nasally. You're alright. There's some tissues over there if you want to go blow your nose. I'll read them out for you. So you've got the ally, which allows you to re-roll behind the brushes. James, behind the brushes, right in front of your face.
Yeah.
right there, right in front of you, behind those brushes.
Oh yeah.
You're looking almost straight at them. Give it a good blow. Discard this card after rolling a cunning to replace your roll with a 5. March of Time. An immortal must discard an ally if able. Draw and activate an encounter card.
Yeah, I have the ally.
Yeah, the ally. Alright, so this goes back on the top of the deck.
Yep. Oh, so I see you're kind of casting through them all eventually.
Yes, exactly. Eventually we'll run out of the right there?
What?
I don't
want to blow my nose.
Right. So it's my turn. So what am I going to do? I think I'm going to go back. I'm going to do a lay low as well. So I get to roll my influence. I get 7. 1... 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you see the difference here is I now have drawn some red ones, so these white ones won't go back into the deck.
Yeah. And you don't get to keep them either, you don't get to pick from them, pretty sure.
Yeah, I do, I just pop them back. Oh. I get to pick from what's in my hand, but these ones can't go back into the
I'm just sitting right across the radiator, and it's like amazing.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to take, what's an encounter card?
So, an encounter card is...
draw and activate an encounter card.
So, it's where, so you draw, should I do a demonstration?
Is that those things? Oh, yeah. That's those things. Okay, cool. Okay, so let's not do that yet. So I'm going to take this ally.
You fight someone.
Death card.
Not a player. So.
So now all of those cards go away.
Death card.
Yeah, and these two go back into the top of the deck. So we're now through there. Okay, back to.
Okay.
Keep up.
Yeah.
I'm
sorry. Okay.
You only have, how many allies are you allowed?
One.
Oh, okay.
No, you have one ally.
That's okay, because I can. If I discard an ally, which I'll do now, I gain two hickeys. As long as I have none, which I have none, so I'm okay. So there's my ally, Death Cult. But, in control?
Yep.
I'm just gonna hop into the lay low. Okay. So I get to up my dice for one, so I actually broke my normal influence. Seven. Ooh, seven cards. Three, four, five, six, seven. Ooh, one card away from the cavalry.
But then these all go back. So I've got the ally, which is true love. Discard this card to cancel the effects of the fake card. Gang. So that's another ally. Discard this card to cancel the effects of another ally. Spy Master. Discard this card when another immortal discards an ally to equip the discarded card. Discard this card when another immortal discards an ally to equip the discarded card instead of. If you discarded the Death Cult, then I would. And I had this ally out, then I could discard this and get the Death Cult.
Oh, okay.
The next one is a politician's life. Which is, looks good because it's +2 on the influence and no minuses. I might do life of business again because that's plus. So that's basically +1 both things except for power. So we still need. Okay, yeah. I'm going to go for a life of business.
Okay, so I'll give those a shuffle.
So that gets. discarded. So this,
so
you do
this. Okay.
So
green
goes up to yellow.
So I'm then going to go for
purple.
I might also go for a low. Yeah. I don't feel ready to go hunting yet. I've got 8, so I think that's pretty much the entire deck.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm ready to sell your... I'd like a life, really.
I'm
going
to put this token for acquiring that life
card. Well, I have to play that, it's the only life that's left. So
Dad,
I'm going to take that. I know, yeah. I'm going
to
take that.
Well, they're plus 2 on influence.
Yeah, so my influence goes from a D8 to a D10 to a D12.
That's pretty good.
So I'll take that.
That's really good, though, because that's what you do to these. So see how many cards for this one, see how many cards you draw, right. And your initiative.
Yeah, cool. Right, so then it's back to being my hand, and it comes back, so is yours. And we've got a roll off on influence, yeah?
Oh, that's going to be a hard one to beat.
10.
7.
All right.
So you're going first for once.
So then I'm going to go for a hunt then. So I get to upgrade my influence dice from a D20.
Oh no, Dad, you don't roll for this one, you don't roll how many cards you draw.
Oh, okay. You just take the top one.
Yeah.
And they've been shuffled, yeah?
Yep.
Cool. Conflict. Donald Grant, Flight Lieutenant. Cunning 5. Success. Gain 4 quickening tokens. Discard this card.
You can't roll Cunning 5.
Can't roll Cunning 5.
You got cunning.
So I can discard my ally to upgrade one of my dice 2 steps before rolling. So I'm going to upgrade that from that D6 to a D8. So that means I have to get rid of that. Let's see what happens. I get a 6, so I beat him. So I gain 4 quickening tokens. 1, 2, 3, 4,
discard,
and discard that card.
Okay.
But I'm now without an ally.
Also going to hunt with you.
Alright.
Okay. So Juliet.
Juliet Visionary.
So success, gain a weapon.
Oh, nice.
Discard a life.
Oh,
okay.
I just got old, it's got a life, yeah.
Yeah. And then gaining weapons, getting one of those.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Influence 4.
Yeah, it should be alright. Should be alright, influence 4.
10, 6, 5.
Yeah, so you gain a weapon. And you got the Claymore. Oh, it's Colin McLeod's weapon. You got my weapon, man. Can't believe you got my weapon.
Claymore, when there's only 2 mortals in the arena, upgrade your power die. Cool. So, you can only ever have 1.
So that's that, yeah? Okay.
Yeah.
But it looks like you can have multiple lives because lives aren't.
I'll read it out for you. Lifeguards. When the lifeguard is activated, you may choose to discard any lifeguard you've already equipped and place it horizontally as a stat or discard card.
This is what you do. The yellow lines line up. So then you know. It's 6 plus 8 plus, like that. That makes sense. There you go.
No, because that leaves, that is an eye for influence. I just think that would work. It needs to be the opposite way around.
Oh, yeah, that's
weird,
isn't it?
Unless that's just an error on the cards.
Yeah, I wonder if that's a
problem. Well, it says here you may only have 2 horizons, you can have 2 lives. That's awkward. I thought you could only have one. I read that one.
So you can have 2 life cards. That's alright, we're learning. Yeah. Fine.
It's literally your second game.
So you're right. I think either these are printed wrong or these cards are printed wrong. Because if you line them up, that would have double on my cunning.
I think it's just easier to keep it down there because it tells you what.
so that's it. You're all over the place. You got a cold.
Yeah.
All right, let's drop it. Right, so it's, I'm rolled off again, yeah?
Yeah.
I've got 7. 9. Nice.
3. Okay. I'm going to hunt. So I got Forest
Wanderer.
So,
cunning 3.
Cunning 3. Yeah, I'm good on that. So, if you're the top 3 cards of the year deck,
you can so, you can use a quickening to re-roll it, kind
of. I'm not that bothered about the top card of the year deck, sorry. But I'm not that bothered.
So discard the top card of the year deck. Okay. Yeah. So we're one less down the year of deck. Alright, cool. So my turn. I need to go back into the year of deck, I think.
I
get six cards, which again I think is the entire deck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's only 5 cards left in here. I'm going to take, discard this card to cancel the effects of a fake card. Yeah. So I'm going to take this ally here. True love. Alright. That's it. Back to the next
turn. Basically, with the gathering, it's finally resolved
in
the face, so you flip the board over as well.
Yeah, the board. Yeah, there's another side
of
the board. Yeah.
And then finally resolve the dual face again and again to only one
immortal stand. Yeah.
Last. Okay.
Alright, so now we need to do roll off again. Influence roll, James.
Okay.
I got 10. 5, so I go first. Right, this time I am going to go for a hunt.
I want to get
Jason Bard, who has a cunning of 3, which I can only roll the maximum of 4. And I get 4. Okay, so I beat him. Reveal the top 3 cards of the era deck. You may activate one revealed life. I don't think there's any lives left in here. No, there's no lives left in there. So.
You want to keep on playing this today and try and get
perfected?
Yeah, I think it's quite an easy game.
Yeah, I think it'd be better with more players. It's
yeah.
You need, because otherwise it's just you and me.
Basically, you and I
just rolling off against each other constantly.
Yeah, so I'm gonna go here and I get.
So the game needs a bit more to it.
Caesar Saxon, influence 2, success, gain an extra quickening token, fail, discard an ally. So influence.
It's got to be the influence of 2, it's easy.
7.
I thought I was going to have one. And the quickening are obviously useful in the duel, right? Because when we're actually fighting in the gathering, we can keep using them for rerolls.
Yeah.
Right, my turn. So.
I'm going to try and harvest
the
rest of the
Lalo
cards.
Okay. 7. Oh. That's me first. Now, I'm pretty sure it's only allies in the lay low deck, so I'm not going to bother. I'm going to go straight for a hunt. Look at the top 3 cards of the fake deck. Gain 2 quickening tokens and discard this card if I win. And this is against Arcadius Gragius, the wizard. And I get, it's an influence roll of 5. Now, because I'm alone in that space, I get to upgrade my influence dice. So I go from a d12 to a d20. So hopefully, well, let's see. 13.
Has this got like what clash of that what type
they are? So I smashed him.
So you're a Highlander.
Yeah. So look at the top 3 cards of the fate deck. But why would I?
As you can see, who's going to die? So you can see how desperately you need to avoid your yourself and use your company.
Look at the top three cards of the fight deck, but why would I bother? Unless I can pop them back in an order. Is that what it's saying?
Yeah.
Well, I'd rather do that, because I'd probably set myself up for death. I'm not even going to worry about what's there. I'm just going to shuffle them. They are what they are.
Yeah.
I think I've got more chance. If I was like, oh yeah, well, I'm going to win the first duel, I'll probably die horribly.
Yeah.
So that's that. So I've got more quicking tokens.
I'm gonna move here and just slightly upload my thing. Just so I can fish out the rest of those cards. Well, let's see what card I'm gonna get. I just got an arrow. Couple of contacts. Scout this card after my influence to replace your role with an aim.
That might be useful.
Yeah.
That's it, so that goes there. Okay. And then back to our...
I wish it swapped the power on, mate.
Influence roll.
Okay.
I got a 7.
That's
why you're trying to be you. Now, I'm worried because I want to get a weapon. So I'm going to go hunting again. Cunning rolls. I hate cunning rolls.
Oh, because of the claim rule, I'd actually have the green. It says I get to upgrade my power.
Yeah, but it's no good either. 4. Oh, I beat him. These are the top 3 cards of the era deck, which you may activate one more real life. But I know there's none in there, so there's no point. So this was a gain the twiddling token and discard this card.
I guess you're so quick, Dad.
Right, your turn.
Okay, so...
What am I doing now? I should be rolling... Okay. Oh no, that's cunning.
So I get to draw up 9 cards from
you. Just a whole lot. But unless you're taking something out of it, we won't reduce it.
Yeah.
You can later get the arena card. There's an arena card there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you want this arena, these are real quick
to take before Molly Jewel. Right. Just 2 cards left in the era deck. Alright, so then we both come back again.
Gathering.
Roll off. Influence. I got an 11. Yeah. I'm going back into the hunt.
I've got a 7 or a 12. Skip straight to
it. So I need a cunning of 4, which is the maximum I can roll. Get a 1. I'm going to re-roll it. Well, I'm willing to burn through some influence here. 2. I'm going to re-roll it.
Oh yeah, you want that weapon, don't you?
I want that weapon bad. 3. That's nice, not enough.
Oh.
This is a make or break. 2, not enough.
Well, this is
where
down for
1, not enough.
You can't get claymore.
4, right, I got it. So it all goes back in, but I gain a weapon. Which I gain the monstrous blade.
Ooh.
Upgrade your power die. When you're in the arena, the will of the duel draws 2 fate cards and chooses one to activate. So that's just become, I'm a D8 now, I'm a D8 on my thingy, and I get to gain a quickening. So I've still got 4. But that was worth it. Okay, so your turn.
So,
it
goes here.
Okay, 7, so you can pick up all of them.
I didn't bother
upgrading my thing. You just need to take one so you can discard it.
I
can cancel the effect of a fake card.
What I'm going to use the thing that can cancel the effect of an analog card. Just in case you try to do that.
Right, cool.
That is modern.
So we're almost there, right?
Yeah.
So we go back into our thingies.
Would you just like to do that so you roll
d20. Actually, yeah, I'll just go into there.
Start.
I'm only going to discard. I'm only going.
We didn't even see
this. Yeah,
first.
Exactly. Seven. And I got a six, so you're going first.
Oh, yay! Good, I can go past. Okay, so. Event, open warfare. Move yourself in any of the walls of the arena before the jewels turn each wall of the arena of influence. The mortal that rolls highest upgrades their power dice twice for the jewel. Okay, so.
We both need to go there and we roll influence. So before, yeah, so influence is probably good for you as well. I mean, I think five. No, a six. Um, so I get my energy thing. All right, so I really want that. You got a nine. Okay, you got an R re-roll as well then. I mean, you can win and re-roll. I got a six, that's not enough, so I'll re-roll again. I got a seven, it's not enough, yes. I'll re-roll it again.
Oh, thank you for me, I rolled the second place.
I got an 11, which you can't beat. You can re-roll as much as you like.
Okay, so that, right. That power so is I get to go, by two.
But it's already upgraded. Yeah, so it's already an 8, so it becomes a D10.
Oh, I really needed that.
It's a D,
terrible.
D8 with my weapon, D10, D12. It's D12 for power. Right, so what are you on power?
I'm on D6.
Right, okay.
Double
it. Two. Three. Oh. You can re-roll it.
No point.
You sure?
Yeah.
Wait.
I'll set you up for the gathering.
Alright, but you do remember I get to draw two cards.
Yeah.
Alright, but if one of them's behead.
Most likely dead.
No, you're not dead.
Oh.
So I'm going to go with collateral. Now, do these come out of the game or do they go back into the deck?
They come out of the game. Okay. So eventually you'll get
beheading. So choose an immortal in the arena. That immortal loses an ally. You're going to lose that ally.
Well, apparently that was the effect of an ally.
No, not quite. But so luckily one wasn't. I just chopped your head off because you're dead. Right. So then we come back to here, right?
Okay.
Roll off. Two.
Three.
Right, you're good.
Okay, let's hit the hunt.
Are we going to the hunt?
Yeah. Let's show some fight. Move yourself in any of them.
Okay. So we're both in
okay, what is it by the way?
But that's out, isn't it? Or does that stay?
That does stay. That stays until someone else suddenly comes and places it. Each immortal
loses one before rolling
one
a jewel.
Oh!
They both lose. Both lose a token. Right. Okay. And then I'm now rolling. I'm not rolling that anymore though. I'm only rolling a
D8.
I've
got six.
I got six. Six. Nice. I got an eight. Wow. Which you can't beat. So that's you. That's you.
Okay.
So I get to take two cards.
Oh, I'm waiting for it to come out. It's beheading, is it?
It's a beheading. Ah, oh, I just spin. Shush!
And then you get your claymore back.
Yeah, and I take my weapon back from you. Yeah, I beheaded you, James.
Yep.
Nice work. Good game. So what do you think of the game then?
I think it's really good.
Yeah?
It'll be better with lots of more people.
Yeah, I think it's a bit slow, isn't it? It's a bit of a roll-off game. You roll against me, I roll back. Yeah, yeah. But it's made by the same people that made Labyrinth, so
yeah.
It doesn't surprise me that the mechanics are fairly similar.
I'm gonna pack up then.
Yeah, all right, so I'll end the stream then. I don't think anyone, I think some people, I saw some people jumping in and saying hello, but not many. But we'll end it there. Thanks guys for watching. Say goodbye,
bye.
James. Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.